Good morning, my reader friends. My name is Erin Rogoff, and welcome back to my BookTube channel, where today I am going to be doing a re-review of Catching Fire by Suzanne Collins. Catching Fire is a young adult fiction, science fiction, dystopian romance, and it is so worth the read, or let me rephrase, it is so worth rereading. In the series, we have The Hunger Games, Catching Fire, Mockingjay, and The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. I do not have this book yet, and no, I haven't read it yet either, but I plan to. As far as the tagline goes, sparks are igniting, flames are spreading, and the capital wants revenge. So far in this book, Katniss Everdeen and Peeta Mellark have won the 74th annual Hunger Games. Katniss should be relieved and happy that it's all over. However, nothing is the way Katniss wishes it to be. Gale is keeping her at a distance, Peeta has turned his back on her, and rumors of a rebellion against the capital are arising. A rebellion that Katniss and Peeta may have helped start. When Katniss is forced back into the 75th annual Hunger Games, everything changes yet again. No tributes are exempt from the games, so Katniss has to go back into the games with Peeta. Katniss is told by President Snow to make everyone believe that she's actually in love with Peeta, not just act the part of being star-crossed lovers. And the games can't be stopped, so not even with a wedding or a baby bomb, what will stop the games? When Katniss and Peeta are forced back into the games, they make allies like never before, with Finnegan Maggs, Joanna, and Beatty and Wyrus. When Katniss is forced to remember who the real enemy is, not the tributes that she fights against, not the game makers, but President Snow, what will Katniss do? Will Katniss catch fire and burn amid the flames, or will she engulf her enemies in those flames and never be forgotten? What did I like best about Catching Fire? I absolutely loved how, when I was rereading it, I found details that I totally missed before. So, I love how we get a history of the Hunger Games and the history of Haymitch Abernathy. And then how we are able to hear about the history of the Mockingjay pin and its importance throughout the books. And then I also really enjoyed how I have come to love this series instead of blatantly hate it. And no, I am not sure why I first hated the series when I read it. This book is still wildly popular, and there are so many ratings that I had to narrow down to just a few. Amazon rates the book 4.7 out of 5 stars. Barnes & Noble rates the book 4.6 out of 5 stars. Goodreads rates the book 4.3 out of 5 stars. And according to Google users, 95% of readers enjoyed this book. And my rating, a solid 4 out of 5 stars. It was a really great book, but it wasn't my favorite, so that's why it isn't a 5-star rating. Who will I recommend this book to? Fans of iconic books and movies, which the Hunger Games trilogy totally is. It is iconic. It was iconic when I was a teenager, and it's still iconic now because we get to hear about President Snow and his history, which I think is so cool. And then I would also recommend this book to fans of science fiction and dystopian romances. So anyone with a reading bug like me. Will I have a watch marathon of the movies after I finish reading the books? Yes, absolutely. I have a feeling I'll be noting every single detail that didn't make it into the movie adaptations, so it will be irritating, but my mom and I will still love watching the movies together because we do that like once a month, watch The Hunger Games. It's so much fun for us. As far as my story with The Hunger Games trilogy, when The Hunger Games trilogy first came out, I was in middle school and my best friend was obsessed with the series. And she wanted me to read the series, but I was going through this reading phase where I wouldn't read any books that anyone knew of, so any popular books I would not read. I would only read the unknown books. I was late to the game, but 10 years later I finally read the books and confirmed a dislike of the series. And as I reread these books now, I've actually turned from a hate to love bookish romance because I hated the books at one point and now I love them. It is funny how things change, don't you think? Anyway, that is all for today, so if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button to show some support, subscribe to my BookTube channel to get more videos like this, turn those notifications on to be notified when I have a brand new video uploaded, keep on reading, and have a great day, everyone!